Thank you. Show without me. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Marty's Corner. I'm your host, the late Marty Shields. All of a sudden, I hear the music start playing, and I'm walking in, and all of a sudden, everyone's yelling at me. Welcome to Marty's Corner as we come to you live from Channel 20 here on the studios of Wilson High School in Hacienda Heights, our 35th show. I'm not going to mess with this. We welcome you to our show. We have a good audience here tonight on the show. I just feel so rumpled. Rumpled. One thing we need to talk about before we get going, we have a new website that we showed on the show last month, the new website here on Marty's Corner, and we're glad to say that a lot of people have been locking onto the website here and talking to us. One thing I do want to tell you was that the gentleman who made our website wrote me a letter the other day and said that he was leaving his container and he's going to be gone for a while. No, it's not what you think. It's not what you think. The gentleman who did our website, I left a bunch of beer cans all over my front yard, so I called the cops. Now he's in the pokey. So that's what's going on there, huh? No? The cult thing going on in San Diego, all those guys killed themselves down in San Diego. I heard a couple jokes about the cult. I didn't make these up, so I'll go and tell them to you anyhow. Apparently, I guess, a couple of the gentlemen were castrated in the cult. You see that, right? A couple of guys, yeah? Well, that's good to know there's a couple less nuts in the world. One more joke. As I said, a couple guys were castrated, and apparently a couple of the nurses actually did the procedure. One woman actually was a nurse and did it surgically. The other woman, she nagged the rest of the guys for about 4 months, and they just... No? Okay. We just celebrated Easter break. Easter break was just over a couple weeks ago, and I realized what I call Easter break. Our kids are home by themselves. And my wife's 20-piece china set is now a 37-piece china set. That's what they call it, Easter break. Easter break. No, don't clap. I didn't write that at all. Recently in the news, the son of famous rock and rollers, Ike and Tina Turner, was arrested in Los Angeles. Apparently, Chris Turner, 41, was shoplifting. I guess he was stealing some condoms and some bubble gum. The kind of things you need on a date, condoms and bubble gum. He went before the judge, and the judge said, you got famous parents. Don't they love you? And he said, what's love got to do with it? Got to do with it. Who needs a heart when a heart can be broke? There you go, Robert Anton. We talked about earlier, past shows, I have a mouse in my house. We have a mouse, yes. We have a mouse that's probably been there about 5 or 6 months. And smart mouse. This thing, we've done everything to get rid of this mouse. We've eliminated his food supply. We've brought in traps. We've brought in a cat. In fact, one night I was so desperate, I stayed in my living room with the lights off with a baseball bat and tried to sound like a piece of cheese. Trying to get this mouse. Yes. But he wouldn't come out. And I read somewhere just the other day in the journal Nature. I know Steve reads that all the time. The journal Nature. It says that mice that live in environments that are interesting and exciting and happening and moving all the time actually grow more brain cells. So this mouse is getting smarter because he lives in my house. Lucky me, right? And of course, that means one other thing, no cast party. Not tonight. No, not tonight. 2, 3, 4. Thank you, Steve. In sports, the Major League Baseball has announced they have a new soda sponsor, Pepsi Cola. Is now the official sponsor of Major League Baseball. Pepsi, huh? Yeah. Oh, Coke. It's funny you should say that because apparently the New York Yankees had a problem with that. They didn't know how they're going to snort Pepsi. Oh, you like that one, don't you? Yeah. Thank you. Major League Soccer just started. The LA Galaxy is doing well. LA Galaxy, yeah. Although there was some problem in the league last year, apparently the mascot for the Kansas City Whiz got in a little trouble. You can only guess what he looks like, the Kansas City Whiz. I won't go any further with that one. We have a good show for you here on Marty's Corner. We're going to be doing a call-in spot a little later on in the show for free T-shirts. So all you who have been watching the advertisement the last couple weeks here on Channel 20, call in, and we're going to give away some free T-shirts to the audience at home, and also the audience here tonight getting free T-shirts tonight. But we do have a good show for you tonight. We have a gentleman on tonight who has recently been seen in a very controversial film, and he'll be on tonight from the movie The People vs. Larry Flynt. Richard Paul is here tonight. Richard Paul is here on our show. Tattooing is becoming very popular lately. Everybody's getting tattoos, old people, young people, girls, guys, everybody. And we have a tattoo artist on the show tonight who will be performing some body art for our pleasure. Franco is here tonight. Franco here on the show. Live tattooing. We have a comedian who joins us for the first time. He'll be on to do some funny bits for us. Mike Tolodisener is here tonight. Mike Tolodisener is here tonight. Big Mike. We also have a feature song by Viva, Malpache. Lots more. I'm going to tie my tie. We'll be right back. Guys, get us out of here. We're back live on a Friday night. How you doing tonight? Good audience tonight. All right. And I have my tie tied now. I'm with Leann. How you doing, Leann?
Oh, great.
It's so nice to have you back.
Well, thank you. My
heart is still racing from the beginning spot, so I'll calm down just a second. How's the wedding going? Leann's getting married in August.
August 2nd.
Yay! How's the wedding going? How's the wedding going?
It's going just fine, you know. It's just that whole wedding thing is a racket. I'm thinking we should get into that business, so.
Just elope.
It's too late. The deposit's already done,
oh, really?
And they're non-refundable. But can I get married on the show? I'm thinking a little mock wedding.
In fact.
You could marry us, maybe? I don't know.
We thought about that. We thought about bringing a camera. Camera to your honeymoon.
All right.
Well, it's sweeps week, so we're going to be
here. Hey, that might work. All right.
Speaking about weddings, something happened here. A gentleman who, I don't know if you saw this or not, who was a director on our show last year, was in the Inquirer just a couple days ago.
Ooh.
And we didn't know about this till someone called us up and let us know that he was married. We didn't know he was dating anybody. And we definitely didn't get any invite to the wedding, and we know why now. Our director for a whole year last year, Skip Bellier, married Dee Wallace. You know Dee Wallace? Give you a shot of that, please.
Oh.
Dee Wallace, she was a mother in E.T.
Yeah.
And Cujo and The Howling. And I don't know if you get a shot of that. Is that Bette? There we go. Can we get a shot of that somehow? And there's Skip and Dee. Skip and Dee. And and we wish them all the best. And they're the Inquirer. And Dee, you have an open invitation to come to the show anytime you want to.
So
we hear from Mr. and Mrs. Skip Bellier.
Huh? Woo!
Must have lost that invite in the mail somewhere.
Yeah.
We have a guest here, Marty. He's one of the first guests on the show this evening. Just recently, the movie The People vs. Larry Flynt got a lot of hubbub, a lot of bad feelings about that in certain areas of the country. But this gentleman's on, and we're glad to have him here. One of the stars of The People vs. Larry Flynt, Mr. Richard Paul. Richard, come on out. They got me stuck. How are you doing, Richard? You know Leann? Oh, you have a seat right here, Richard. Have a seat, sir.
There you go.
We'll hook you up. There you go. How you doing, Richard?
I've been in show business, you know. I know about
all right.
You're an old vet, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
So you made it down okay, I'm guessing, here and everything like that?
Yes. Well, we used to live around here.
Whereabouts?
We lived in Whittier.
Oh, by Red Hill.
I met my wife, Patty, in a mental hospital.
We
were working at Metro State Hospital
in
Norwalk, and that's how we met. She was an undergraduate, and I was a graduate student. And then I ran off and became an actor instead.
You ran off to become an actor?
Yeah.
Where'd that come from?
I don't know. I think it's when I was a kid, you know, the first time. Well, I imagine you know what's like. You get up and you tell something funny and they all laugh. Well,
hopefully, yeah.
It's really addicting, you know. It's like, don't try it. Don't get jokes. If you do, you'll be addicted all your life.
That's what happened.
Yeah.
You have one of those faces that looks familiar. Everybody has seen you around and where
it's a tired face.
It was a tired face.
You've seen it everywhere.
You were in Carter Country on
Carter
TV?
Carter Country, years when none of you were born here in the audience. One person.
Oh, bless you, bless you.
That was 77. I was mayor Teddy Burnside, your mayor by landslide. And then I moved north to Cabot Cove in Murder, She Wrote. I played the mayor on that show. I did a couple of years.
Yeah. Very nice.
Now, Jessica, that's 47 people have died in the town this year. Cabot Cove is the murder capital of the world.
And it's not their fault.
No, it's a dangerous place to live at Cabot Cove.
Are you doing any TV lately? Have you done any TV lately?
TV? Oh, yes. I met Roseanne at the premiere of People vs. Larry Flynt, and she was very cordial. And I said, how would you like to do my show? I said, I'd love it. So they called me a couple of weeks later, and I did just a little bit, but it was nice Rosie
to me, huh?
Yes.
Well, that's around, though.
Well, I don't know. You're still on the air.
That's
she's
true.
She's going off, so I'm going with the winner. Over
there we go, right here.
No, fool me.
Yeah, I'll tell you everything I can get. Let's talk a little bit about the People vs. Larry Flynt, a controversial movie. How'd you get involved in that project?
As a matter of fact, I found out later that it was really Larry Flynt who recommended me.
Oh, is that right?
Yes.
Wow.
I had played it once before with Bernadette Peters and Kevin Spacey, and it was called Fall from Grace. It was a TV movie on NBC. And I was really the villain in the piece because I took away their ministry and then didn't give it back to them.
The Jim and Tammy story
from her perspective.
Right.
I remember once I had worked on it for about a week and then I had a break for a couple of weeks. And let me tell you, Bernadette Peters, she's better looking than she is in the movies or on TV. She is just gorgeous.
Put together, isn't she, huh?
Oh, she's wonderful. Yeah. And I remember she was saying goodbye to me and she said, which camera? Where are you? Oh, I'm looking for a red light. Oh, there it is. She looked at me and said, see you later, Dick.
Ooh.
It was a thrill. It was a thrill. I couldn't find my car. I walked around in the lot for days.
So
he suggested me. Now I had to go and interview. I interviewed with Milos Forman.
Milos.
I went to his hotel. Wow. He was barefooted and had a cigar. Pretty relaxed, laid back. And he said, well, you certainly look like that guy, don't you? I said, well, I hope so. I'd said, Lord, make me look like a TV star. I was hoping Tom Selleck, you know, Jerry Falwell.
Well, we take what we can get, huh?
Yes, we do. We're still in show business.
Yeah.
So then I interviewed a second time with the cameras and put it down.
We have a small clip that you brought with us. What are we even looking at? Set up the scene that we're looking at.
This is the scene where I'm testifying. Now, I'm not going to show you the whole scene because I only got 8 minutes, folks, and I don't want to show this whole stuff.
Is that how long you're in the movie?
So this is where Jerry Falwell is suing Larry Flynt for writing this scurrilous cartoon. I don't know. Have any of you ever seen this or know about this cartoon?
Oh, Hustler, anybody?
It's like an ad for a wine. It's a phony ad for a wine. And in it, they say that he had sex with his mother in an outhouse.
Okay.
So this is a scene. The other guy talking here is Edward Norton, who's a wonderful actor. So this is part of the scene.
Let's take a look at that. We could go and roll that in the studio.
In a recent poll of Good Housekeeping magazine, I was voted second most admired American behind President Reagan.
Good Housekeeping. That's... I mean, hey, you're famous, right?
Well, I suppose you could say that.
Mm-hmm. Reverend Falwell, have you ever had sex with your mother?
Absolutely not.
Never? I mean, you never in the outhouse, as Hustler magazine suggested?
That is an absurd question. My mother was a very godly woman, and as close to a saint as anyone I have ever known.
I'm sure she was. Reverend, have you ever preached while you were drunk?
Drunk?
Yes.
Never.
Never. I mean, you never even had a few too many at lunch and then went back on the radio once?
That is a totally outrageous suggestion.
Totally outrageous?
Totally.
You don't think that some people, Reverend Falwell, despite your reputation, might have reason to believe that you could do that?
I would find that very difficult to believe.
So really what you're telling me is that nobody could reasonably think that these statements about you were true.
Yes, that's what I've been saying.
Okay.
It's great acting.
Yes,
great acting. You're also involved in another charity I know called Actors and Others for Animals.
818-755-6045. I'm pretty sure if you want to call and get information, you know the situation. But they send people into hospitals and clinics and things with pets and people that do this.
Richard, thank you.
Rise to the top.
We're going to go over to the tattoo artist. When you stay right here, have you ever seen a tattoo live?
I don't.
Okay. We'll take our glasses off during this bit. Stay right here. Can we have Richard Paul real quick? Richard Paul. We have a tattoo artist, as I said, Franco, who will be doing a tattoo on a young lady, and if we kill him, we have to go live to our conference room where this is taking place. Oh, the magic of television. Anytime you're ready, gentlemen, take it away. And I don't know if Franco can even. There we go. There is Franco working on Tiffany. Can you hear me out there, Franco? Can you hear me, Franco?
Nope. No, we can't hear you.
Okay, great.
Maybe he's trying to concentrate.
Well, probably they don't have the monitor on, so he probably doesn't hear me. But he's doing, what he's doing right now is what they call is hitting her with a needle. And because
he's trying to run away.
And because of the fact that.
Hello.
There he is.
Oh, okay.
How you doing, sir?
So what do I say? Anything?
Oh, I don't know what you want to say. He doesn't know, he can't hear me.
They got start now?
Oh, it's okay.
Okay, my name is Franco. I've been in this business for 38 years. I was born in New York. I was a carny for 12 years, at 17 years of age to 21. I have made it to California because I heard the weather was better.
All right.
So I'm out here now.
Where you work?
I had a shop in Tampa for almost 17 years on Hope Boulevard called Franco's Tattoo 78. I had an accident, got a pin in my ankle, had to recuperate for a while. But I'm back now and I'm ready to tap.
Okay, we're ready with Franco. Let's go ahead and take a look at what you're going to do now. Now, you're using the upper back because of why? As opposed to like your stomach.
I'm going to show everybody what total freehand is. People out in the tattoo world use templates. You get the size of what's on the picture. They can't bring it down, they can bring it up. I'm going to show you what a total freehand illustrator designer is. My shop is located on Arrow Highway 20540. It's called East and West Coast Tattoos in the Sunrise Center. Now, if you want to come up there, I'll do some great work at you.
Okay.
I'm going to show you what I do with this young lady now.
Okay, we're going to come back to him throughout the show. He's going to go ahead and start working on her. Well, we need to go away to a break. Guys, can you hear me out there? Yeah. Let's take it away. Guys, get us out of here. Franco, go for it.
We're back! All right! Back live on a Friday night to Marty's Corner. And with me now is my other co-host, Frank Atencio. How are you doing, Frank? Good to see you, Frank.
Yeah, doing pretty good, Marty.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hi, Mom.
I forgot to ask you before the show. You got that 20 bucks you owe me?
Oh, yeah, from last show? Yeah, I got paid yesterday.
Okay, cool. I know if I didn't get you on the air, you wouldn't give it.
Wait a second. I just got paid yesterday. Where did all my money go?
Where is it?
Oh.
Oh. I see where all your money went, Frank.
That's where all my money
went. Well, I'll take a check.
I'm good for it.
Are you?
Yeah.
I'll take a check. We recently went down to the new opening of a theater here in the San Gabriel Valley, the largest Cineplex here in the Valley now, the Edwards 18 at the Lakes. We took a camera crew down, so if we could, let's take a look at the video of Edwards 18 at the Lakes. Anytime you're ready, bring up the volume in the studio and let it go. Let it rip, guys. Edwards at the Lakes.
And tonight we come to you from the opening of the Edwards 18 at the Lakes here in beautiful West Covina. Hello again, I'm Marty Shields, and tonight we're going to take a look at not only this incredible complex that just is now opening, but also some of the festive flavor of the night. We have a Jamaican band behind us. We got Darth Vader walking around here, some stormtroopers. Everything you'd want on a Wednesday night at the Edwards 18.
Hey, who are those guys interviewing the mayor?
Those guys from Break TV, they think they're so cool.
Yeah? Those guys are going to be on the show this month.
This month?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, that's okay. We're just going to edit all this out.
There you go.
Yeah,
they won't know
we're talking smack about them. That's okay.
That's it.
Welcome to the opening of the Edwards Entertainment Center. I am Bruce Schutte, the current president of the West Covina Chamber of Commerce. I might say, Glendora, move over. Covina, move over. You've always said you had a downtown Glendora. You've always said you had a downtown Covina. Welcome to Uptown West Covina.
We're speaking with the biggest mayor in the world, Mayor Mike R. Tui. Mike, how are you doing tonight?
Great. Thank you very much, Marty.
Incredible facility you have here in West Covina. Tell us a little bit about what we're looking at.
We're looking at the largest movie theater in L.A. County.
Yep.
It's an 18-plex, 4,000-seat, all-stadium. It's the first all-stadium theater in L.A. County, and it will be for probably 1 or 2 years. So we're expecting great things out of it.
What's this theater going to do for the economy here in the city of West Covina?
It's going to bring in a lot of people to shop and eat at our restaurants, so that will revitalize the Glendora Strip Avenue.
Show me the money!
The chairman of the board and the chief executive officer and my dad, James Edwards Sr.
Oh, okay. Mr. Edwards?
Are you the cable guy?
I'm the cable guy.
Okay.
How you doing?
Bernice would come at 12 o'clock midnight. We'd go out on our date then. I couldn't leave the theater. I did everything there. And where do you go at 12 o'clock at night on a date? You got it? And out of that has come a wonderful family.
I'm here with Darth Vader, one of the stars of The Empire Strikes Back. How are you doing tonight, Darth? Good. Glad to hear it, Darth. Real talkative tonight. I see some of your stormtroopers are hanging around. Are they up to no good, I'm guessing? Glad to hear that, Darth. Darth, you have a good time. It must be hell to eat popcorn through that mask. How do you do that? Okay, well, say no more, ladies and gentlemen, the incredible Darth Vader. Darth.
All right, now it's fun, but, you know, we're just trying to figure out what we have to do to get Marty's Corner in the city of West Covina and what we have to do that, you know, make it possible.
You heard it, Mike. We want to bring you down to the show real soon.
Anytime.
Thanks for having us.
I just want a very good show. I don't want nothing that will compromise my political. The belly dancers, my wife will kill me.
We'll make sure we'll keep it real clean when you're on, real clean.
You got that. Well, it's not bad. The belly dancers will get me in trouble.
You're going to get yourself in trouble.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you very
Appreciate
much.
Appreciate it. Mike Tui, Mayor of West Covina. Take care. Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, geez.
That's it, huh? A big thank you to the city of West Covina, Mike Tui, and, of course, my cameraman on that shoot, Pat Warting. Thank you guys very much for coming down and helping me out. We are now joined by a gentleman who has his own TV show in West Covina on WCCT. He's a producer, writer, cameraman. He probably mops up afterwards. One of the best shows on cable access television in the San Gabriel Valley. The producer of Break TV, Pat Prefontaine. Pat, how you doing? Matt.
It's Matt.
I'm sorry.
Can I call you Pat?
My good friend Matt Pat Prefontaine. I can't even say it. How you doing, Matt?
Fine. I also got a few other people that helped me out. I'd like to...
Why don't you go ahead and...
Matt Slater, he's in the crowd here.
Matt, thank you. There's another Matt.
Can we call him Pat, too?
He helps me out on a lot of shoots, and he's like the mic person. He holds the mic.
Oh, okay.
And my other cameraman, Dennis.
Dennis, Bye. Back there, take us. There's Dennis on camera.
And basically what I'm trying to do with the show is just promote places for teens to go, keep them out of trouble. And we promote a band on all our shows. And basically what we want is people to call us or come in that, you know, have no experience, that want to do something on TV. And we're giving them a chance to...
You have a phone number you want to give out real quick?
Yeah, it's 818-974-9120. And that's my room phone number, so you can call at any time and wake me up.
There you go, ladies.
All you ladies out there can call me. But
yeah. Now, you're doing a behind-the-scenes tonight here on the show, right? You got a cameraman here doing behind-the-scenes?
Yeah, we got a Dennis back there. He's doing
he's some watching work. all the mess-ups here. How you doing, Dennis?
And
how not to run a show.
Yeah, we on our show, we promote things from rock climbing to paintballing, from we saw you at the Edwards down there, and we covered Laser Star and a few other events, and we all also promote bands in our show, you know, give them a break and some publicity.
Well, you get that number one more time, Matt. What's the number one more time?
It's 818-974-9120, and anyone can call up. We'll give you a chance in our show. Our little logo is it's your show. Not ours.
Okay, Matt, get back to work. Thank you so much, Matt. Take off your microphone. Let me get that microphone off you. Get back to work. Thank you so much. All right. See you later. Take care. Matt,
can I have a job?
Matt.
Can I have a job?
You don't need a job. Just give me that $20. We have a comedian now to Marty's Corner. He'll be making, as I said, his first appearance here on the show. A very funny man. Can you please give a warm welcome to Mr. Mike Tolodisener? Mike, come on out. Mike, come on out.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I feel as welcome as Louis Farrakhan at Denny's.
Oh.
Very pretty audience you are. Give yourselves a round of applause. You're very, very pretty audience. Now, I just wanted to mention this. You know, earlier when I came in, I noticed somebody walking around. Really nice body. Hope I can say this on the air. Really, really lovely breasts. Would you mind standing up, sir? Please. Now, this is very good. This one of the things I like about being on television, nobody's smoking. Nobody's smoking. And I usually do this in nightclubs and bars. Usually a lot of people smoking. So, in fact, last Friday night I had a gig, guy sitting right in the front, smoking like crazy, right? And so I actually had to stop. I actually had to stop my act and say to him, sir, you know that your secondhand smoke is killing me. He says, look, pal, I don't give a crap about my health. You think I'm concerned about yours?
Yeah.
And it's not that I never smoked. I actually used to smoke, and I got the patch, right? And it was great, you know, cleared up my lungs. I quit smoking. I now have patch cancer, ladies and gentlemen. Well, thank you.
Yay! Yeah, patch cancer.
Thank you. Thank you for applauding patch cancer. That's very, very nice. So it's been kind of an interesting week for me. I wanted to surprise my wife this week. I wanted to hire a cleaning lady, right, for clean our house. So I went through the phone book looking up cleaning ladies, and I finally find this lady, and I call her up on the phone. I'm negotiating with her, and I offer her, like, you know, $40 a week to clean the house. But I got just a little suspicious. She asked me, how much is that in crack?
Oh, yeah, well, there you go.
You like it. Thank you very much. Thank you,
Robert.
Thank you. And then my wife and I are out to dinner, right? We're finishing up. My wife gets up, puts on this fur coat. People from the next table come running over. They're all upset. They say to us, yeah, do you know what you're doing? The coat's fur. Do you know how hard that is to get? Do you know where that comes from? I got really aggravated. I finally said to my wife, look, I've had enough of this. Honey, give them their coat back. A little bit about myself. I've been happily married for 26 years.
Woo!
My wife's been miserable. Oh, she says I'm not responsive during lovemaking. I guess it's true. The other night I came home, found her making love to some guy. I didn't say a word.
Yeah, they're clapping for that.
But I've asked her. I said, honey, what would be the best thing I could do to improve our lovemaking? She said to me, don't participate.
Oh.
She actually said this to me. She said, you know, you're a poor substitute for my vibrator. I said, well, hold on, wait a second. You mean to tell me that you have better sex with the vibrator than you have with me? She says, no, but the vibrator's got a better personality.
Oh!
But I have to admit this, she surprised me the other night. The other night, wakes me up, 3 o'clock in the morning to have sex. 3 o'clock in the morning, she says, get the hell out of bed, my boyfriend's coming over. But I shouldn't complain. You know, I had my carefree bachelor days. I dated all kinds of women. Like, I dated this French girl. She told me she liked to do it doggy style. Ate out of a bowl, peed on my shoes. Dated this girl, and this is actually a little bit embarrassing. It's a little bit embarrassing. Dated this girl, told me she was kind of turned off because I didn't have enough genital hair, you know? So I got some of this minoxidil, you know, the stuff that grows hair, okay? Rubbed it around, all right? Didn't do a thing for me. She grew one hell of a mustache. It was unbelievable.
Oh.
Just a couple of things before I go. I have to tell you about this. My wife's brother, it's a little controversial. My wife's brother, I think he's turned into a real bigot, right? I get this letter from him, and he's complaining about the Jews. He writes, the Jews. He says, the Jews run the government. He says, the Jews own all the banks. He says, the Jews control the media. I said, listen, Homer, if this is bothering you, do something about it. Get the hell out of Israel. And this is the last thing. Last thing, totally amazed. My 92-year-old grandfather this week admits to being a cross-dresser. 92 years old, finally admits to being a cross-dresser, right? Shows me a picture of himself dressed as a woman. I'm totally blown away. I think I went out with him when I was in high school.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen.
My name is Mike Cohen Israel. Thank you very much.
Come on over, Mike. Come on over, Mike. Are you going to have a seat, Mike? Have a seat right here. We'll hook you up real quick. There you go, sir. Why don't you hook yourself up right there? There you, that's just fine. Oh, no, there you go. Right in here.
Oh, right here.
There you go.
Okay.
Mike, we're running a little bit short on time. What do you got coming up real soon?
I'll be doing the Golden Hearth on May 27th.
Okay.
And that's in La Mirada. And Dario's on June 27th.
Okay.
Dario's is in Placentia.
Placentia. And you have a phone number you want to give out if anyone wants to get in contact with you?
Yeah, please. I also do professional speaking engagements for anybody that's interested.
Okay.
Numbers 714-348-0949.
Well, thank you so much for Mike. Mike,
okay.
Go on Disney. Stay right here, Mike. We need to go in for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back, guys. Get us out of here.
If you show it, they will watch. If you show it, they will watch. I'll get my own community access show. Yeah. And I'll have on bands and dancers and prominent people from the community. And if I show it, they will watch.
Dad, are you okay?
Oh. If I show it, they will watch. If I show it, they will watch.
Okay.
Oh!
Dad!
gentlemen, back live to Marty's Corner, and we are back in the conference room with Franco, who's working on Tiffany. Franco, how's it going so far?
Great. We got it almost done right now.
Tell us about people that normally who want tattoos done for the first time. Should they really take a lot of time thinking about it, or they just, the impression is, guys get all soused up on break and they all go and get tattoos. It's kind of a personal decision that you have to make. And yeah,
that's the wrong time. You should always do a little research. Don't be rushing anything. Pick exactly what you want.
Right.
Look around different shops. See if anything strikes your fancy.
Yeah.
Then come in and get your fancy. But don't rush it, because it's on forever.
How you doing, Tiff?
Pretty good.
Does it hurt?
It doesn't tickle.
It doesn't tickle?
But it's bearable.
It's bearable?
It's bearable.
Okay. We're going to go back and we're going to go to our T-shirt contest. So I'm going to go ahead and give this microphone over to Leann on the television. And then I will go back into the studio audience. Here's your microphone, Leann.
Hi. I'm back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm back!
That's pretty creepy looking, Marty.
Is that pretty creepy?
Do we have insurance for the show?
Oh, that's fine. We're fine. We're all set up. We're going to go ahead and try something that we've been advertising all week on Channel 20, that we're going to be doing a live call-in spot here on the corner.
Something that's never, ever worked.
Never, ever worked. Never. So we're going to try it again. So all of you that are watching at home, and today's date is April 11th. It's Friday night. It's 9:45. So we're going to take phone calls. And put your voice on the air and ask a couple questions, and you get your free Marty's Corner T-shirt. And let's see if anybody calls.
Is my mom eligible? No, she won last time.
Maybe I should give the number, huh?
Why don't you do the audience while they're with you?
All right, 333-2427. Frank, let's go and pick some numbers. You all were given tickets. Please open your tickets in the audience, please. People are calling?
Somebody's calling?
Okay, let's hold on.
Hallelujah!
Bless you!
Bless you! I can't believe it! Is
all
it a
right.
relative?
All right, we're ready to go on the air. Who's on Marty's Corner? I can't hear him. Hello, who's on Marty's Corner?
Howie.
What's your name?
Howie.
Ellie?
Howie.
Howie, okay, Howie.
That's why it's never worked. Marty's
That's why I can't talk. Howie, how are you doing? You watch Marty's Corner all the time?
Yeah, ever since November.
That's good, huh? Since you've been here at Channel 20. All right, Howie, you've been watching the show tonight, I'm guessing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, here's a question for you, Howie. Really easy question. What was the name of the movie that the actor was in? What movie?
The People versus Larry Flynt.
We got a winner! All right, Howie, what we're going to do is don't hang up yet. We're going to take you back to Leann, and she's going to go ahead and give you a secret password. Then we're going to want you to call back at the end of the show, like about 9:05, and we'll get your address. Thank you so much for calling.
Actually, we're going to go to his house.
Don't hang up, Howie. And we'll go to the next call, so let's go ahead and get his address. Wow. Amazing, huh? Let's go. I know, amazing. Let's go ahead and get one out of here. 333-2427, give us a call live. I don't believe it. Okay. All right, what number? Okay, cool. I'll pick one. All right, anybody who has the number six? Number six? Six? Six, we have a winner! Yay! All right, would you like an extra large or a large T-shirt? Large, give her a large, please. 333-2427. No, there's larges. 333-2427. Please give us a call. Is anybody calling? No one's calling. All right.
Okay.
Why don't you pick one now, Frank?
That was our fan.
That was our yes.
Howie.
One person. I want a T-shirt. 333-2427. It's live April 11th. You get a free Marty's Corner T-shirt. I don't think we have this many people in the audience.
It might be. I mixed them up.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah,
okay.
So you call
okay.
That number.
Number 28. And we have 28. 28? We have a winner! Would you like a large or extra large? Extra large piece of that gentleman in the back? Just go and go.
No, he's your friend Brian, Marty.
Well, let me.
He hangs out at your house all the time.
I'm going to throw it to the first row. The first row throws it back. All right, go over that way. Any phone calls? 333-2427, Leann?
No.
Nothing?
10 minutes.
10 minutes? Okay, well, let's go one more real quick. And the band wants to do a song because they're all giving me dree looks. All right, let's go one more shirt here real quick. We'll go to another one later. All right, the number 11. Number 11? Number 11? 11, anyone? Number 11? Number 11? Howie, are you still watching us? 11? No, I'm not giving it to him. Number 43. Winner, we have a winner in the bag, all right. What size T-shirt do you want, large or extra large? Extra large.
Check
all right.
His ticket.
Okay, let's go ahead and go over there. Okay. It's just time to go to the Viva Malpache. The guy's been over there waiting patiently.
Yeah.
We have a shot of the band here recently. And what magazine was this again? What was this?
La Pinion.
There we go. Okay.
That's their card.
Here's their card. Can we get a shot of that? And this is the first time the whole band has been here to play with us, right? Normally it's the corner combo, but we have Gio and the rest of the guys. Ladies and gentlemen. Okay, the number is 818-456-9082. Viva Malpache. Guys, take it away. Viva Malpache. We're here for them.
Tiro, vale un sancocho, pero me cae mal. No puedo escapar, la tendencia te falla. Y sin subir la cabeza, cuando no hay nada que mirar. Si mal empeora, si no sé si viviré. Malita fe, malita fe. Y si el sol brilla es solo para quemarme. Malita fe, malita fe. Para ganar hay que perder, y a mí no me queda nada. Algún día me sacaré la lotería sepulcral.
Gracias.
go to the tattoo guy, please.
How's that? Can you hear me now? Hey! We're back live to Franco, and he's working on the tattoo artist. He's getting close there. How's it going, Franco? Okay?
Yeah, we're almost completed right now.
Okay, you got a few more minutes?
Yeah, about three, 4 minutes.
And what's your address one more time, Franco?
205 40 East Arrow Highway.
And that's east to west coast?
Yeah, it's near Bonnie Cove. It's a Sunrise Plaza.
Okay, thank you again. And again, Tiffany, thank you so much, sweetheart.
Oh, you want, sweetheart?
Okay, we're going to go back to the calendar of events there. Let's take it back to Leann and Frank, and I'll join them in just a second. Take it back to the studio, guys, in the control room. Take it away back to the studio anytime.
Well, I tell you, we could take over the show.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
We're back. Woo! Okay, do you have any calendar events?
Actually, I have an update on the webpage.
Okay, do you want to do that first? Or?
No, I'd rather do that later.
All right, let me start then.
I'm back, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey. Yeah, well, okay.
Yeah, right.
Woo!
Who cares, man?
You want me to start?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Okay. Mount San Antonio College, otherwise known as Mount Tech. Art gallery will premiere its 51st annual juried student exhibition from 6 to 9 on Tuesday, April 15th. Isn't April 15th something else we should know about?
No.
No? Okay.
Mike's birthday.
All right. Woo.
Mike's birthday.
Check out Fusion. And for more information, call 909-594-5611, extension 4328.
Okay. Also, make sure you watch another show here on Channel 20. April 24th, the other hip show here on Channel 20, XTV, is having their official pajama party.
Yeah!
And so make sure you watch that here. Leann, go ahead.
Oh, okay. Hacienda Heights Recreation Tennis Club will start a tennis clinic during the summer months, so we'll bring this up again, for children ages 7 to 12, starting July 9th, and so they can learn how to play tennis. Call 818-855-5383.
Now, Frank, what are we looking at down here?
Come on, Frank.
That's our URL.
URL.
Uh-huh. Forum Resource Locator.
Oh, very nice.
And we've been getting letters. People have been writing us letters, actually.
Oh,
and
really?
Yeah, we were shut down by the FCC and the Christian College. So we got restarted back up again.
Yeah,
all those links that I
saw. So we're up and running?
Yeah, we're up and running. So please, if you have a computer, please log in. Write us an email that you did it so that we can still get it.
Now, do the guys in the band, have you guys got any gigs coming up? Viva Malpache, what do you got coming up? Jill, anything going on?
Hey.
Yes, actually, we're going to be at Mr. C's on April 25th. That's a Friday night. Montebello on Whittier.
Whittier?
On Whittier
and
Montebello. Mr. C's.
As you say Marty's Corner, they get in free?
Only if they say it three times.
Oh, okay. All right.
But, there's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Yes. We are Viva Malpache, just so everyone
yes,
knows
by the way, this is Viva Malpache. I said they've been with Spanish us for about 3 months, band. Right? The best rocking Spanish band, I think Robert said on the last show.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Rocking Español. Actually, and this is our number. 1976. 1818-456-9082.
Okay, we'd like to go ahead and promote the next month's show here on the corner. It's May 2nd. Awesome. It'll be our Cinco de Mayo show.
Yeah. All right.
It'll be May 2nd, and we're going to do a special tribute to Richie Valens. Some of his family members are going to come down to the show.
Really?
Yes, that's right. That's right. Yes, yeah, right, Mike. Really. And and we're going to have some performances by I guess his nephew, Ernie Valens, is going to be doing some songs for us. So that's May 2nd. Make sure you watch that show. We'd like to thank our pizzas yes. This evening from Anna Marie's Pizza and Hacienda High
School. All right, thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy.
That's our compensation.
That is. And again, we want you to make sure you watch next time. Like I said, get hold of us on the website. And oh, I'm sorry. They're telling me to come on. Go too slow. This is Marty Shields on behalf of Leann, Frank, Viva Malpache, Crazy Mike.
And the live studio's audience.
Everyone
yes.
here at Marty's Corner. See you on May 2nd. Take care. God bless. Marty's Corner. Goodbye.
En la fiesta poquito a poquito me emborrachaba. Te apareciste en un instante frente a mí. Sin introducción ni explicación me diste un beso y un trago que no era ron. Sin embargo, baby, hey, todo mi alrededor tiene todo el color. Hey, santera, hey, santera, hey, santera, otra forma de enamorarme.
Happy birthday, Jesse.
Despierto y me encuentro atado y aturdido. Gente bailando con espíritus montados. Se desnuda delante de mi hijo.